Sports brings you Thursday night in the NBA. This is Brian Anderson, joined courtside by Grant Hill and Clark Kellogg. Our reporter tonight, Allie LaForce. Allie, it's all yours.
Thanks, BA. I mean, Anthony Davis is shining with the Lakers. LeBron said, quote, "There's a reason we wanted him here. He's a complete player. All he ever wanted was a chance. And now that he has it, we haven't seen the best of AD yet. He is just scratching the surface." Makes you excited, BA.
They make one heck of a tag team. Thanks, Allie. Let's see some of the numbers here for the last handful of seasons for LeBron James.
And he's gone cold over the last 10 games, guys. His scoring numbers are down, and he can't seem to get out of this rough patch. He's got to get himself going tonight, or they'll start losing patience with him.
Now let's take a look at the Bucks' opening lineup. The foundation of this team, Middleton and Giannis, the 3 and 4. Jrue Holiday out there with Grayson Allen. And it's Portis in at the 5, down low. And for Los Angeles, Anthony Davis is out there with LeBron James. Then there's Avery Bradley. Then it's Trevor Ariza. And it's Westbrook in at the 1. And at this point of the season, Clark, scouting reports should be pretty set. How important are they for teams?
Extremely important. I mean, knowing the other team's tendencies is part of preparing to beat them. So we see some teams who swear by advanced scouting. I mean, it's really a pillar of how they operate. They'll use complex defenses, can spot opponents after timeout plays, and really put all of that information. It's about data accumulation and then aggregating that data and using it effectively to hopefully give you an advantage in winning the game.
I love great defense. Just quick to establish his feet, and he takes the hit.
And not afraid to put his body on the line either. He took a shot for the team in that situation.
Antetokounmpo outside. And no good. And Los Angeles the other way now. They just couldn't come out on top last time they took on the Bucks. That one in Milwaukee.
They hit a couple big shots, but overall, there was a lack of consistency. Just not their night at the offensive end.
And you know what? If you're not going to outwork your opposition, then you typically are going to get outplayed.
Middleton passes to Holiday. About a minute into this first quarter, Portis with a screen on Davis. 6 to shoot. James against Middleton. Over James. Middleton, no good.
He expects to make every one of those, and we expect him to make them too.
And Chris Middleton, a great three-point shooter. But he's got a deadly mid-range game as well, Grant.
Middleton is just flat out a shooter. Can pull up from anywhere on the floor. If you give him the mid-range, he'll take it and punish you.
Holiday against Westbrook. Takes a 13-footer, and that one hits the back iron. Now Los Angeles with it, coming off a win against the Blazers.
Thanks to their stellar defensive intensity, they registered a ton of stops in that one.
And the hustle they showed on that end was infectious, contagious. I mean, their squad really got after it.
Now here is James. Impressive numbers he's putting up, averaging just over 28 points a game.
There's no stopping that. AD is too long and strong to bother that alley-oop.
The Bucks have gone 0-for-3 from the floor to begin this one. Offensively, it's been a struggle for them.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
Pass to Antetokounmpo. That one falls. Nice feed that time from Holiday.
I tell you what, he clearly is one of the best players in the league who does not get the same kind of gas than other guys do. But there's no better all-around guard in the NBA than Jrue Holiday.
Davis can't hit. The Bucks trail. Antetokounmpo finds Holiday. Antetokounmpo, a screen on Westbrook. The shot by Holiday, no good. For Los Angeles, they've gone 2-of-4 so far. Antetokounmpo against James. Westbrook, the pass to James. Davis with a screen on Antetokounmpo. James with the ball, guarded now by Holiday. Releases. And the Lakers get it back. Here's Davis. and misses it off the right side of the rim. The Bucks have gone only 1 of 5 so far. Here's Antetokounmpo. Middleton from the outside sends it home from three-point land.
Rhythm and timing so important in the game of hoops. Middleton using both on that pull-up jumper.
Here's Bradley. Allen defending. Davis with a screen on Middleton. Right side Davis. Bradley with a drive. Deflected! They get it back. Count the basket. And so it's Milwaukee with it. Middleton passes to Portis. Now here's Middleton. The three is up. Bradley grabs the board. James outside. Changes up. And it's laid in by Davis. Davis has got his third basket on the night right there.
Well, LeBron James is clearly a tremendously talented passer. When a guy is open, he'll get him the ball.
And Holiday, here we go. Portis for three. And that's good. His first bucket of the game.
He's consistent from out there, especially when you give him that kind of room.
James with the ball. Boy, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Davis against Portis. And Chris Middleton gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. Time called here. Los Angeles decides to talk it over. And the Lakers going with a whole new group out there. And the Bucks will go for a different look here. Norris checked in for Giannis Antetokounmpo. Connaughton comes in for Middleton. DiVincenzo, he's checked in for Allen. And it's Hill in for Holiday. Outside Monk. Horton Tucker on the wing. Clock at 6. Anthony outside. He buries it from 3.
Pick works well there, but the defense left a lot to be desired.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
Now here's Hill. He's been productive, averaging just over 7 points a game. Now here's Anthony. Tight defense on him. Oh, got that one up quick. Anthony's got 5.
Well, you got to respect the jump shot of Anthony because he's got the ultimate green light. And because of that freedom, he's a dangerous guy on the perimeter.
Here's Portis. 17 points for him. Last game against Washington. Howard with some nice D.
That's going up against a defense that knows your tendencies.
Milwaukee has gone 2 of 3 from three-point land so far. Monk against Hill. That shot off. Great D that time from Monk. Here's Reeves. DiVincenzo covering. Anthony outside. From 15 feet away, it's hauled in by Portis.
Oh, you have to love the spin move there, but he couldn't quite gather himself for the shot.
Nice shot by DiVincenzo.
And the three-point shot of DiVincenzo is dangerous. Defense cannot allow him to get airspace from there.
There's a minute 34 left in the first quarter. Anthony with it. DiVincenzo picks him up. Pass to Reeves. Now Howard. Shoots over Portis. Here's Reeves. Here's Horton Tucker. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Left side Hill. Here's Nora. The shot is good, and this game is back to even.
Already plus five in terms of rebound margin.
Pretty clear. They're dominating that area. They've come out with a lot more energy and effort so far.
Now here's Anthony. What a tremendous game he played against Portland. The shot won't fall. Milwaukee goes the other way with it. DiVincenzo on the wing. Out to the right wing. From behind the arc. That shot missing. And for Los Angeles, they're shooting around 40% early on here. Horton Tucker on the wing. 15 seconds left in the first. Back to Anthony. The shot misses. That'll count. That shot off the mark. Tie game in Los Angeles. And we'll be back with you shortly. And as strong as he is, no question, Giannis takes a lot of hits.
There's going to be a lot of teams that are going to come out and try to be physical with me, try to hit me, knock down to the floor. But I just got to keep my composure. I think I have great teammates that always talk to me and tell me, Giannis, stay focused, stay in the game. You know, I know that I'm going to get a lot of contact, and I'm just ready for it.
Giannis not trying to get baited into any extracurriculars after the play is done, Grant.
Well, as the star player, you got to be smart. I mean, focus on dominating and trust your teammates to have your back.
And it's been a pretty even game here after one quarter of play. Taking a look at the Lakers' performance here, guys. What are your thoughts?
Well, it's simple. When you can dominate the boards at both ends, you can control the second chance touches.
And, you know, their rebounding advantage has been glaring. Simply outworking them on the boards for that entire first quarter.
Johnson is out there with LeBron James. Then it's Anthony Davis. Then there's Avery Bradley. And it's Westbrook in at the point. That's who's in the game for the Lakers. Now here's Johnson, averaging around six a game. And not gonna go. He misses his first attempt of the night. Now here's Antetokounmpo. Middleton outside. Lets the three fly. James with the rebound. Things just don't seem to be clicking for them offensively.
Yeah, they really need to find a way to get back on track.
It's Johnson with a drive. And blocked with his palm. What a defensive play. Antetokounmpo, the pass to Holiday. And here's Allen. Pass to Antetokounmpo. Puts it up from 12, and Davis with the block.
Davis so good with his timing and length to get up and deny shots.
And here in the second with about a minute and a half gone by. The shot by Holiday, no good. The Lakers trail. Well, Anthony Davis helped rescuing the Lakers from some lean years. In the six seasons prior to his arrival, they'd missed the playoffs more times than in the previous 65 years of the franchise.
And a year after they got him, they're hoisting the Larry O'Brien Trophy. And now, with his new contract, he should help them compete for a long time to come.
Holiday passes to Antetokounmpo. Driving inside. The Lakers with a rebound. Davis has got six rebounds in the game. Pass to Johnson. Westbrook with it. Westbrook with a screen on Middleton. Here's James. Banked it in off the glass. James has got his first 2 points.
Yeah, you know, LeBron's mental strength is just so, so focused that nothing much phases him. He stays locked in.
And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Jrue Holiday signed a four-year, $134 million extension to remain in Milwaukee. His coach, Mike Budenholzer, said, "You can't appreciate the strength and the physicality he brings until you see it night in and night out. What he does defensively, once you're around it, it's even more impressive." Guys?
All right, good stuff there, Allie. Now here's Middleton. 13 points in the win against Washington. Outside Hood. Antetokounmpo outside. And that one's good. Middleton.
You know, this is what happens when you combine center size with developing point guard skills. Giannis running the offense to perfection right there.
Here's James. Westbrook finds James. Davis with a screen on Middleton. From 11 feet away. Second shot opportunity. Count it. Davis has got 4 points now in the quarter.
Davis using that athleticism to battle it out on the glass. From in that tight, hard to stop AD.
Ariza's checked in for the Lakers. Matthews, he's checked in for the Bucks. And Grant, you played almost two decades in the league. What do you think some of the biggest highlights in your career were?
Really just, you know, playing on some great teams with great players, the relationships, the experiences. I didn't win an NBA championship, but I am more than blessed with having an incredible 19-year career.
On defense, the Lakers. They've only given up 6 here in this quarter. Holiday from long range. Rebound by the Lakers. Davis has got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. Pass to Bradley. Davis with a screen on Allen. Back to Davis. 6 on the shot clock. Over on Antetokounmpo. And it's good. Off the back rim and in. Davis has got 12 points.
At the offensive end, he's been assertive and efficient, guys. A big reason why they hold this lead right now.
Holiday against Westbrook. Back to Antetokounmpo. Rebounded by the Lakers. James finds Westbrook. Westbrook with a screen on Middleton. Here's James. And it's James with the jam.
Still possessing incredible athleticism. LeBron James, when he attacks like this, you can almost forget about stopping.
Now Holiday. Coming off a 22-point game against Washington. Here's Antetokounmpo. Pass to Matthews. Outside Holiday. Screen by Antetokounmpo. Holiday passes to Antetokounmpo, and they pick up 2.
Boy, he is so dangerous from this area, guys. Even when Giannis is defended tight, he powers through it.
The Lakers in the lead. James outside. Kicks it out to Westbrook. Takes the 3. Giannis with the rebound.
He's got to be mad at himself. You won't get a better look than that.
For three, Allen. Pass to Holiday. Now Antetokounmpo, hounded by Westbrook. Fades. Antetokounmpo can't connect.
Boy, just not scoring with the efficiency he'd like to. Tough quarter for him.
Here's Ariza. There's the three. Giannis Antetokounmpo grabs the board. Antetokounmpo has got four rebounds now. Middleton with a screen on Westbrook. Back to Antetokounmpo. Middleton outside. He nails it, and we're tied. Middleton's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Yeah, you know, when you shoot the ball as well as Middleton does, you want to be hungry in looking for your shots. I mean, shot hungry is a good thing when you've got the stroke that he has, mid-range and long distance.
And the Lakers will go for a different look here. Howard's checked in for Davis. Anthony comes in for James. Horton Tucker, he's checked in for Bradley. And it's Monk in for Westbrook. And the Bucks will go for a different look here. Portis, he's checked in for Antetokounmpo. Nora comes in for Middleton. Connaughton, he's checked in for Allen. And it's DiVincenzo in for Drew Holiday. Here's Horton Tucker. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Pass to Howard. 1:43 left in the second period. Five to shoot. The Lakers got to get one up. Late clock. Here's Ariza. Kept alive. Here's Horton Tucker. Monk passes to Anthony. Goes back up. Ooh, a terrific shot on the turnaround. Anthony's got 7 points in the game.
Whatever the defense gives, that's what he takes. A sign of a skilled offensive player.
Pass to Nora. 56 seconds left in the second period. Matthews, count it. One for one to start the game.
Love how Matthews uses the pick and roll. Excels at making the right decision in these sets more times than not.
52 seconds left in the half. Here's Ariza. Anthony in the post. Hauled in by DiVincenzo. Milwaukee has gotten 5 of 11 threes to drop so far in this game. The three is up. He can't hit that time. And Los Angeles the other way now. After this one, they're off to Los Angeles to take on the Clippers. And that'll be their only game on the road before heading back home. That one goes. Count it.
We know he can shoot deep, but he also has a nice touch inside. So Monk has a lot of confidence wherever he's shooting the ball from.
DiVincenzo, the pass to Portis. It's an even three-on-three break. Here's Monk. He hits the back iron and sinks it. And now a four-point Laker lead.
And Monk is fantastic in fast break situation. Knows exactly where to go and what to do.
And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that's been very close so far. The Lakers on top, up four. All right, now let's check in with Allie LaForce. Allie, what do you have?
Thanks. I'm here with Frank Vogel and Coach. The offense seemed to get on track in the second quarter. What changed for you?
We just settled down offensively. You know, it seemed like we had some nerves early on in the game. We were attacking the paint, trying to play extra pass basketball, but we were a little hesitant. I thought we just settled down in this quarter.
Hopefully more aggressive in the second half. Thanks.
Okay, Allie, appreciate it. And folks, we'll be back after halftime to begin the third quarter.
Hey there, everybody. Shaq says hi. Kenny says hi, too. Yes, we are in the midst of the NBA season and a perfect time to see how things are coming together in the West. At the bottom of the standings, we've got some teams that are not just way back. They're way far back.
Man, that's far back as our hairlines, far back as we go as these reclining seats, far as back as we can remember Shaq being less than 7 feet.
And the Ball brothers are in the building.
And guys, how about Anthony Davis in that first half we just witnessed? Outstanding job asserting his will and going to WORK.
The man is dominating now, though. That remind you of someone, fellas? I'll wait. Anyway, he's taking high percentage shots that leads to high point totals. Does that remind you of anybody, fellas? I'll wait. And again, he's in full control of the interior right now. Awesome to watch. Does that remind you of anybody, fellas? I'll wait.
Glad you could join us. Ryan Anderson and crew are ready to take it away for the start of the third quarter.
Second half of basketball is upon us, and we may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game we've seen so far. A fantastic game from Anthony Davis in this one.
And he was a beast on the offensive glass in that first half. How can they slow him down?
And you know what, guys? I think it starts with having a body on him every time a shot goes up. I mean, they've got to do a better job boxing out.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, this second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams trying to gain an edge. So on the floor for Milwaukee, Middleton is the three with Giannis in at four. Grayson Allen is out there with Drew Holiday, and it's Portis in at the five spot.
You wonder what the score would be if they weren't controlling the glass.
It's clearly been their edge, and in a close game like this, you look for every edge you can find.
Now here's Davis. 12 points for him. That one's good. 7 for 10 now.
Things really rolling for AD now. This could be a big night for him. B.A. and Anthony Davis, you got a big man who can give you 28 a game and contend for Defensive Player of the Year. Enough said.
Here's Middleton. Give him 8. Pass to Allen. Lets it go from deep. And that comes off the assist by Middleton. Allen's gotten himself going here. His first points of the game on the deep ball. And Davis standing 6'10 with a 7'6 wingspan. His sphere of influence, let's call it, is gigantic.
B.A., I love that phrase, sphere of influence. And that's exactly what A.D. had. Multiple first-time all-defense selections and rightfully so. This guy gets it done at both ends.
A tremendous mobile one block that we had to see again. Great send-back.
Yeah, what a play. I mean, that'll have the offense thinking twice about taking shots in his presence.
Now here's Holiday. His numbers are solid, putting up around 18 points a game. 13 feet out, and it's Milwaukee scoring again.
Middleton, a scorer by nature, that time showing you he can find his teammates too.
And the Lakers have possession. It's a one-point game. James outside. Davis with a screen on Antetokounmpo. James can't get it to go. The Bucks have got 2 of 3 from the floor in this third quarter. Allen on the wing. Checked by James. Here's Holiday. And Holiday powers it home.
Aggressive move that time by Holiday. He's the engine that makes this offense churn.
And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. And here's James. Westbrook finds James. High arcing shot. Second chance shot. No luck on that one. Good D by Antetokounmpo. Milwaukee has gone 6 of 14 from the perimeter tonight. Pass to Allen. Now Antetokounmpo. Another one falls for Milwaukee.
They are passing the ball around tremendously right now.
They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
Portis against Davis. Spins to end the run. Just 5 to shoot. Here's Bradley. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up. That free throw misses, and the Lakers making a change here. Johnson's checked in. The Bucks also with a sub. Hood's checked in. And the second free throw is good. And so it's Milwaukee with it. Since the second half started, they've only given up 3 points. They're off to battle the Trailblazers after this one, as they'll be playing at Moda Center. That'll be just the second road game of 5 in a row.
Hey, how about imagining if they were hitting their shots, how big the lead could be? But so far, that's not been the case.
It's Johnson with a drive. Laid it in with a nice touch off the window. Johnson's got his first 2 points of the night. Here's Holiday. He's got 5. Third quarter action, and just under 3.5 minutes have passed. Pass to Allen. Just 4 to shoot. He's off on the layup.
Coach loves the execution, just not the result. That's okay. That's part of the process.
James passes to Westbrook. Antetokounmpo with the block.
You know, one reason Giannis has won Defensive Player of the Year is his agility and mobility. He can stay in front of guys and stay connected to shooters, too.
Now here's Hood. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. To the middle. And the lob disrupted. Not to be. Fast break. Here come the Lakers. Kicks it out to Westbrook. From the arc. Antetokounmpo grabs the board. Antetokounmpo has got 6 rebounds here tonight. James with the rebound. James has got 4 rebounds in the game. Davis, the pass to James. And it's blocked! He keeps control of the ball. Deflects the pass. And that's out of bounds. Milwaukee will keep it. And during the last month's worth of play, here are the top rebounding squads in the league. The 4th spot held by the Bucks.
And last month, this team was active on the glass. Really put forth an effort to box out and track down misses.
Both teams will make substitutions.
Second in free throw percentage, ninth in rebounding, and they are in the top 10 in steals. This is a team that will force turnovers if you're careless with the ball.
And the free throw shooting you mentioned, they're not a team you can be too physical against. They don't waste their chances at the line. Outside, DiVincenzo. Going inside. Softly drops in the floater. DiVincenzo's got his second basket on the night.
Funky finish by DiVincenzo there, using the floater as a way to neutralize the shot blocker.
Pass to Reeves. Anthony with it. Now here's Monk. DiVincenzo covering. Shot clock at 6. Here's Anthony. Antetokounmpo grabs the board. Milwaukee in the lead.
And, you know, with Giannis on the floor, B.A., he's able to completely blow a team out on his own. I mean, he can take over a game with big-time performances. We've seen it. And Antetokounmpo is so long. I mean, he stretches forever, covers a ton of ground.
Here's Reeves. The Bucks getting their last shot to go. And that one's good. You know, with Giannis, as you said, Clark, the numbers he can put up are eye-popping.
Yeah, he can hit you for 40 points and 20 rebounds on any given night, not to mention how well he's grown as a passer. I mean, his assist totals and block shots typically are otherworldly as well.
And Milwaukee has possession. After the Lakers picking up a basket just moments ago. Here's Antetokounmpo, and that one's long.
And I don't understand. Why is he going to the fadeaway? Just go straight up with it.
Pass to Horton Tucker. Here's Howard. Anthony, left side. The six-footer. Rebounded by the Bucks.
It hasn't been all bad shots for him, but you wouldn't know that looking at his percentage from the field.
Back to DiVincenzo. The three ball. And the Bucks hit again from deep.
Boy, you look at the defense, not nearly the hustle or energy at that end of the floor. It's the exact opposite of what it was in the first half.
Now here's Monk. An important role in this offense, averaging around 12 and a half per game.
Like a lot of young players, B.A., it took Monk some time to get going, but he's found his stride in the NBA now.
You know, Clark, with Malik Monk, you can see the improvement he's had.
Yeah, it's about efficiency. We knew he could put the ball in the basket, but now his shot selection has improved, and I think he's gotten better as a ball handler, too.
And he makes a first.
The energy that Monk brings, I love it. I mean, when he's out on the floor, he's giving you everything he has.
Ariza's checked in for Howard. And Milwaukee also making a switch. Portis has checked in. He's perfect from the line this time. Here's Antetokounmpo. He's got 10. Jacks up a three. Ariza pulls down the board. Inside. Anthony with a bucket. Anthony's got 9.
Assertive move. You can tell the game's heating up a bit.
46 seconds left to play in the third quarter of basketball. Pass to Portis. To the paint. Antetokounmpo is doubled. Ariza pulls down the board.
A rare miss for him at point-blank range. That's one he'd like to have back.
Monk finds Anthony. Shoots over Portis. Anthony misses. For Milwaukee, they've gotten 7 of 14 attempts to fall in the half. Here's Connaughton. Antetokounmpo outside. Off with the layup.
And you know, Antetokounmpo is really a master at getting a hand up in the face of shooters. Excellent at contesting his shots and really distracts guys when they get into their shooting rhythm.
It's still anybody's game as we reach the end of three. The Bucks on top, leading by one. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get set for quarter number four. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'll tell you what, this was a no-brainer tonight. Take a look at the precision on this feed. Couldn't place it any better.
Served him up a tasty room service dime right there, boy.
Three tense quarters behind us. One more to go. Thanks for being with us as we get ready for the fourth. Russell Westbrook out there with Malik Monk. Then there's LeBron James. Then it's Anthony Davis. And it's Ariza in at the small forward position. That's the Laker five. Here's James. Lays it up and banks it in.
They're winning the battle down low by imposing their will.
Yeah, it's really been quite a contrast. I like the way they're attacking the middle and at their offensive end.
Now here's Middleton. And there's the drive. He can't get that one to fall. Davis with the defensive effort. Pass to Westbrook. Back to Davis. Outside Monk. Down low. They grab their own miss. Milwaukee has got 7 of their 16 three-point attempts to go in. Middleton passes to Portis. Holiday with the ball. Pounded by Westbrook. The shot by Holiday. No good. The Lakers in the lead. Right side Monk. Outside Davis. Inside. Double team on James. Clock at 6. For 3, Westbrook. The shot's good on the assist by James. James has got 3 assists in the game. About a minute and a half into the fourth now. Boy, they need something to go to regain some confidence.
No question. Way too many empty possessions for them.
Here's Middleton. Second chance effort. And the layup is good.
Well, I tell you what, Middleton getting his hands dirty inside on the glass. We know he can shoot it from outside, but inside points are bonus.
Now here's Westbrook. On the take. Right side Davis. It's Monk on the wing. No good on the 3. The Bucks have gone 1-4 since the fourth quarter began. Here's Middleton. Again, Middleton missing. Los Angeles has gone 1-for-2 from deep in this fourth quarter. Monk passes to Westbrook. Here's Ariza. This one for 3. Rebound by Middleton. Middleton's got 4 rebounds now. Holiday finds Middleton. Up top, Portis. Pass to Allen. Portis with a screen on Monk. 5 to shoot. Allen, the pass to Portis. And then Portis with the dunk.
And once he gets to the rim, it's fairly automatic.
Nothing fancy right there. Just takes his 2 points, moves on.
Hey, guys, I know I'm stating the obvious here, but those could be an important 2 points considering how close this game is.
Here's Westbrook. After the Bucks picking up a basket just moments ago. Pass to Davis. Uses the glass on the layup.
Sharing the basketball is a part of the game that Monk needs to continue to add to complement his shooting.
Portis with a screen on Westbrook. Looking to get it going. The shot by Holiday, no good. For Los Angeles, they've got 3 of 6 shots to go in this fourth quarter. Now here's Davis. Davis drawing the double team. Here's Westbrook. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
And Russell Westbrook on the move once again, this time to the Lakers. Now, what's interesting, I mean, he played so long for the OKC Thunder, and now on his 4th team in the past 4 years. But still, you can't deny the impact when he's on the floor.
No good on that one. Bradley, he's checked in for the Lakers. And he sinks the second.
Yeah, they've really made a concerted effort to get to the line here in the second half.
That's exactly how you do it. Defender pressing up on you, you press right back.
Portis with a screen on Westbrook. The drive by Holiday. Yep, that one goes.
Well, that's an example of the speed and strength of Holiday. Fully on display there. He's so good at scoring on the drive and playing through physical defense.
Los Angeles has gotten one of three to fall from downtown here in the fourth. Pass to Davis. Back to James. Over Middleton. And James gets it to go. James has got 4 points this quarter.
Hard to play better defense than that, guys. I mean, but right there, James simply overpowered it.
Here's Holiday. Rebounded by the Lakers. Westbrook's got 4 rebounds in the game.
He's been just a little off the mark tonight. Really the story of the game so far.
Every player goes through this. When your shots aren't going down, it can ding your confidence.
Here's Middleton. And Davis with the block.
Man, miss after miss for him. When you're having a quarter like this, the only beneficiary is the defense.
The Bucks trail. Portis the screen. To the middle. Perfect pass to set up the lay-in.
And this is just typical of him, always making an impact at crucial moments in the game.
You know, they want the ball in his hands here because they trust him to hit all the big shots.
James outside. Bradley sets a screen. James attacking. Doesn't go that time. Nice D from Allen. Milwaukee has gone 7-for-17 from three-point range so far in this matchup. Holiday passes to Portis. Here's Connaughton to take the lead. James with the rebound. Westbrook finds James. The jump hook. And again, no good by the Lakers. Allen against Davis. Portis outside. Middleton outside. The Bucks need to get up a shot here. Here's Allen. And he didn't get quite enough under that one. And for the Lakers, they're shooting only 36% since the fourth quarter started. Westbrook outside. For three. Unable to get that one. Milwaukee goes the other way with it. Middleton, right side. Portis outside. Pass to Connaughton. It's Portis, high post. Davis on him. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line. And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Lakers.
Anytime you get as many points in the paint as they have, you know you've got a good thing going and you just want to keep it going.
And we're also seeing that power game inside, putting on a clinic in the low post.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to go. Giannis Antetokounmpo's checked in for Chris Middleton. The second, and that ties this game up.
They should be in front right now, but he'll be relieved not to have come up totally empty there.
Westbrook, and from 16 feet away, he cans it.
Well, the thing that jumps out at you about Westbrook is his dynamic athleticism, but his mechanics, very sound, too.
Time now to hear from our reporter, Allie LaForce.
I was able to listen in on what Mike Budenholzer was going over with his team. He pleaded with the guys to stay composed, saying, quote, "Don't try to be a hero out there. We've practiced these situations, and we've got to trust one another. If we do that down the stretch, we win this game. Go get it."
Appreciate the report, Allie. There's a minute 17 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Pass to Antetokounmpo. The fadeaway. No good that time. And Los Angeles the other way now. James passes to Westbrook. Here's Ariza. Davis a screen. Ariza down low. Defended by Portis. Four on the clock. Here's Davis. Oh, he nails it!
No question about it. Such is with Anthony Davis.
There's 45 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's Antetokounmpo. Milwaukee, no good that time either.
Not sure if he just ran out of gas or what. He's been awful ever since the second half started. Not even been a factor.
36 seconds left to play in the fourth quarter, and he commits the intentional foul. Good on the first, and that puts him up five.
Hey, when it comes to stat sheet stuffers, Westbrook is a stat sheet stuffer supreme. Mark that one up, guys.
And so he drops them both, and it's a six-point ball game.
He doesn't waste a chance to pad their lead. It's been some solid free throw shooting.
Here's Antetokounmpo. Some solid defense from James, and an intentional foul right there. He hits the first one, and that makes it a seven-point lead.
And, you know, this guy simply does not age. LeBron remains a dominant force in this league despite being in the league since 2003.
Second one is good, getting both at the line, and it's an eight-point ball game. So it's Milwaukee now. Portis with a screen on Westbrook. For three, Allen. Rebound by the Lakers. Westbrook with it. And so it's the Lakers with the W. A clean win, and one where they clearly showed better energy.
Yeah, so true. They put on a show here at home. And I really think they had that extra swagger and confidence, too.
Well, now we have some time to check in with Allie LaForce. Allie.
Please, see you again.
LeBron, tell me about the importance of how this team closed things out down the stretch.
In the fourth quarter, we turned up our defense and we executed offensively. We finally made some shots on the perimeter in the fourth quarter, and it allowed us to get back into the game and take control late.
What a great fourth quarter. Congrats on the win.
All right, Allie, thank you. And that about wraps it up. For Grant Hill, Allie LaForce, and Clark Kellogg, this is Brian Anderson thanking you all for tuning in tonight. Now it's time to present our New Balance Player of the Game, Anthony Davis.